We've got an interesting story on cycle helmets tonight and whether they're actually killing people. That is a serious question, and it's got a lot of people scratching their heads.
There's an argument that helmets are such a turn-off to potential cyclists that the exercise they're missing out on is bad for them. Here's Mike Thorpe.
Dan Mickelson is a lifelong cyclist who has no problem with wearing a helmet, but he wants to be free to choose when he does.
I'm just going to ride my bike, and whether that's with a helmet or without.
The law says it has to be with a helmet.
Go on in, straight on.
They're mandatory, just like motorcycle helmets and seat belts before them. But you know what? Dan uses that comparison too.
When you're driving an ordinary motor vehicle, you're going to have a seat belt, and more than likely in most cars you'll have an airbag. If you're riding on a bus, you're not expected to have an airbag or a seatbelt. And I think there are differences within cycling as well.
If this debate sounds familiar, it's because it comes up every couple of years.
It really does put people off, and the cycling numbers never really recover.
In fact, we've argued the need for this law since it came into effect in 1994, and actually, there's been argument for its expansion.
If we could amend the current cycle helmet legislation to include all-wheeled objects, so that would include skateboards, scooters and bikes, that makes sense.
Only if you want fewer participants, says Dan.
A mandatory helmet law, a blanket helmet law, does depress the numbers of people taking up cycling.
Well, there's data to back that up, and that's not new either. See this story from a couple of years back.
A 2012 study in the New Zealand Medical Journal found the introduction of the bike helmet law has reduced the number of cyclists by half, increased their chances of injury by more than a fifth, and contributed to 53 premature deaths annually through fewer people exercising.
Surely those costs outweigh the costs of an occasional accident.
Some ditched the treadley because of the skullcap's aesthetics, and to be fair, they didn't launch with the best look.
So, Steve, we think this could be the best investment you might make in your life.
But the stack hat and whatever that thing was called are long gone now. These days, they are much cooler. What's not cool, according to Dan Mickelson, is not being trusted to use the brains that the helmets are designed to protect.
That is a very interesting argument, and I know you cycle a lot. Do you wear a helmet?
Not always, no. Well, certainly not if I'm going to the dairy, and I didn't when I was a kid.
Okay, so why do you choose not to wear one now?
Because I never really did wear one, and I just backed myself not to fall off. But, you know, I'm with the guy in that story because I feel exactly the same way. I think that, you know, as an adult, you've got to make decisions for yourself. I think probably under 18, as kids, you probably should have to. My kids wear cycle helmets, for example.